Hello, I am John, and I am playing some more Total War Warhammer. The only reason why I'm doing it right now, and the only reason why I'm doing the Chaos campaign that I'm doing solo mode, aka off video, is because of the fact that I've gotten to the Timebreaker, or at least what I'm going to call the Timebreaker battle. AKA. Just so that you guys know why I'm not surprised when the epic cutscene happens with the other campaigns, if it even does happen. I'm pretty sure it will, but I don't know. I mean, it may just be a special, like, chaos only sort of thing. But, like, that was right. The blind advisor for every race is actually that corrupted dude. And apparently that corruption that needled straight through his body and turned him into a fuck bag was Tzeentch. And if you guys don't know, Tzeentch is the chaos god of change and deceit, because deceit has something to do with change. So that white crow was the thing that was behind him, if you guys watched the first video with, like, the intro to the whole game. AKA, that is a giant bird demon. Bird dragon demon thing. That is a vicious motherfucker. Well, he walks so derpy on the campaign. It's like he did a normal, like, walk animation, sped it up times 10, and moved, like, half the distance. Was so funny. It's just like, I don't understand, but sure. So yeah, right now I'm fighting his army. Oh, there he is, that pretty bastard. Yeah, he is so one with Tzeentch. I mean, you can just tell. Teal everywhere, tentacle staff with a weird eye. That is so Tzeentch. If that is not Tzeentch, then I am dumbass. Anyway. Pretty much mainly just doing this for the battle. So send you in, send you in, send you in, send you in. I'm trying to be smart this time. I know it's really hard to think of a YouTuber as, or YouTubers who do game stuff like I do, as smart, but I ain't Markiplier. I know he's a smart person too, but he can really fuck up sometimes when he wants to. Fucking damn it, I don't care. I'm trying to do epic shit. We kill that birdie bastard. That birdie bastard is a birdie bastard. He has high threat on everything, right? I will never get over how fucking overpowered. I completely forgot that I called him. Since I put a random banner on him, like that thing. I was just like, you know what? I'll name him something b special. So I named him Bill the Giant Duke. And I just realized Duke looks like both Dick and J Douche. So he is Bill the Giant Duke, Bill the Giant Douche, and Bill the Giant Dick. I'm a fucking retard. When I want to be. And when I don't, I fuck up even more. Jesus Christ. Eh, at least I know I'm gonna win. I mean, just look at that. I have like a fifth of the troops that he has, but I have like almost twice the strength. Like, I almost just want to have all my units converge on. I'm having like three units converge on him. I'm more than bothered I'm gonna be able to take this bastard out. Yeah, just fucking look at him though. Looks like he's like a velociraptor, sort of. I mean, that chunk looks kind of velociraptor. This chunk looks like old, old bird man. He's just like bird, dragon, bastard, piece of shit, man thing. With a Tzeentch staff. That is definitely staff Tzeentch. Though yeah, he is like a lesser demon. Maybe greater demon. Probably greater demon. I don't know. I don't even know if I can call him a demon. I think Korn is the one of demons. Like, Korn is really the only one who its minions can be called demons. Since he is the blood god. He is pretty much Satan. Like, for God's sakes. He is the one who makes sure that blood is spilt quick and easily. He is the one who owns the blood, who owns the skull throne, and he is the blood god. Skull for the skull throne, blood for the blood god. That is the war chant of these chaos bastards. Yeah, at least he's fuck right. Jesus Christ, a double direct hit? And he's casting two spells. Fucker. Oh my god. Jesus. Everyone, charge. Fuck him in the ass. Jesus. Talk about retarded. You're so... Oh my god, I'm not going to be able to get over the fact that these guys and the trolls are kind of like the smallest things in the army. And even he is dwarfed by them. And he is on a bloody horse. It's just like, oh, why is he so slow? Oh, maybe that's the reason why. He's just such a fucking midget. Oh my god, I smacked him flat on his ass. Eat shit, you bird bitch. Thunder! Thunder! Thunderpants, go! Stomp forward, stomp forward, stomp forward. We need to charge. Charge through. Rape them. Wreck them. Eat shit. Bastard kitties. Well, guess what? He needs to run. Fortunately, he can just run over everything. Yes! I wounded the little prick. Now we're gonna just charge those cannons who are point blanking us. Because I kinda don't like to be point blanked with pure hell energy. I don't know about you. Oh my god, they are just shoving that cannon. That is what I call a swarm of death right there. I think pretty well all of the enemy is retreating right now. I won, no problem. I was expecting this to be put bit longer. Kinda wanna see what cutscene there is. And I will probably be changing the mods up a bit with the cheat mod because no, I'll keep for all. A little bit retarded because the easy AI, it likes to mass. And it masses a lot. So if you get late enough in the game and say there's the Empire in them, The Empire has 15 full armies like this, of just some of them lower units, some of them higher units. They have like tons of musketeers, they have tons of those guys, just tons of everything. Just finish it, for bastard's sake. Finish the fight! There we go. Crush the Hammond. Crush the living cannon too, if you want. Wait, are those tied with like cords, actually? I mean, I can't understand if those are testicles or if those are just like hell things. Why was there like a random rain of fire there? Yeah, this is my heavy army, just because he is here. I love these dragon ogres. Like, they are now officially some of my favorite race. Like, Skaven will always be my favorite, but these guys are now a very close second over the orcs. I mean, they are so cool, and they're technically immortal too, because they decided to sell their souls to the chaos gods, but they can only be killed in battle. That is awesome. Mainly for the fact that, like, for some reason, I mean, I can understand the science behind it, but lightning and storms rejuvenate their body so they can technically live forever. I don't know why I just wounded him instead of killed him, but I don't know. I only lost 3 soldiers. I don't even think they were goblins. I think they were like, I don't have goblins. What am I talking about? I don't know who I lost. Gork and Mork made the, I was trying to read that. Gork and Mork made the goblins and the orcs. I just earned almost 1,000. I can earn 2,000. Ooh, oh god, I almost puked. Probably not, but I kind of felt a bit close. I wounded him, so he's my prisoner. Have your own sacrifice. Oh. There he is. There I go. Yeah, fuck. Damn it, son of a bitch. I need to just keep running. The Lord of Change lies broken at Archaon's feet. The latest in a long tally of conquered challengers. This final gambit of the Chaos God Tzeentch has come to naught. Or was that his plan all along? Now even the Great Deceiver must proclaim Archaon the rightful ever-chosen, anointed of all the Dark Gods. His is the right to drive the hordes like an iron fist, to smash civilization asunder. All hail the ever-chosen, Lord of the End Times. Not Lord of the Dark Times, Lord of the End Times. I'm probably gonna fuck in the ass. Where's the... Wait, am I a prisoner? Where the hell is he? Why can't I see this area? Where is my guy? Did he just get wounded?
Beyond your comprehension.
Beyond my comprehension, my ass, bitch. Fucked you 3 times. Well, fucked you twice, but I can fuck you a third if you want. Bow Seeker probably wouldn't be a bad idea, and I'm sorry, but like a bloody, okay, this is actually 14 minutes. That was actually a fair length battle. I think I'll do like one more battle, one more quick one. You know what?
I should probably also do some, like, customs, just for the hell of it. Yeah, I do have some different things, like, two mods. One of them is, both of them are cheat mods, you know, I have some other mods in there that aren't really cheat mods that, you know, they still help the game, it's just they help it in different, lesser ways, like, nerfing the towers so that they're not retardedly overpowered. AKA shooting cross-map and killing weak things with every shot, no matter what. I mean, sure, killing weak things, that's good, but, like, killing five of them in one fucking blow, that's a bit much. And, yeah, now you get to see my other army. I mean, I was gonna have that guy be a third army, but I don't know where the hell he went, if he's even alive still. But, yeah, I think I'm gonna have a chaos, at least one chaos giant per army. Yay, he does have his horse, right? That's supposedly, like, the tallest horse, the biggest horse. All I know is it was fucking vicious looking. How much taller is it? Is it even taller? I don't even think it's bigger. It's the exact same size as those other horses. Yeah, it's supposedly the largest horse in the whole thing. Fucking lying game bastard. I said game and not gay. I don't know why I felt like that was the thing that I needed to say, but whatever. I need to make sure that no one hates me, apparently. Yeah, I'm gonna have the crushers just move in nice and quick. And yeah, that's what I'm gonna call the cavalry, the crushers. That thing is fucking fast, though. And it's on fire. I mean, sure, my guy was also on fire. Yeah, that's what Khorne is. Khorne is also fire, pretty much. But yeah, I remember the pleasure guy's name is Slaanesh. Who was that prince guy? Like, the prince guy is pretty much Slaanesh. The big guy, the Shaggoth, the Dragon Ogre Shaggoth guy, Mr. Sun Eater, Mr. Big Badass Sun Eater, who can crush any foe under his foot, and can kill 1,000 zombies without breaking a sweat. I'm pretty sure he could. I mean, I'm not sure because I can't have armies without, you know, leaders, but, yeah. I guess I could just have, like, a whole shit ton of them if I just have him. I know that, like, four giants and one and two normal Shaggoth can defeat, like, 19 zombies, no sweat. I think they hardly got damaged at all, actually, yeah. Though, the Ragnarok, the giant-ass spider with the weird construction on its back, that thing is overpowered. It has a knockback. So not even the Chaos Giant, which is without like, you know, knocking back giant things, is the biggest threat in the whole game. Because it even found that half health guy low when the Shaggoth Lord found him as high threat. It just kind of means that the Ragnarok kind of needs to get nerfed a bit. I mean, I can kind of see, okay, yeah, it's a spider that's even bigger than a giant. Of course, it's going to knock everything back, but then it's just like in single unit combat, it is the crow. Like, one-to-one combat, it will crush anything. It'll crush a steam tank, it'll crush a giant, it'll crush everything. But, you know, I guess if you get, like, multiple units, like, if you get two giants, it's dead. No problem. No problem whatsoever. Anyway, let's just continue. And I'll do one custom battle, probably a small siege. Probably with the vampires. And then I'll
continue this on my own. If more interesting stuff actually does pop up, you know, I will do little quick videos on them, but I've been playing this game almost nonstop. Like, this is the second day that I've had this game almost completely running. I mean, I've had to shut it off little bits here and there, just, you know, to tweak around the mods and stuff, yeah. Nope, here come the main bulk. Or the strong bulk, I guess. Rawr! Not mistaken, that fire phase does not go to the... Just smack him as best as possible. Do I have to seriously be a certain distance away from myself? That kind of sucks. Oh, Jesus Christ. I think I just hurt my own units quite heavily. We need to get in there. We need to get in there now. Help our Lord before our Lord dies. Oh, here comes the giant, so... this may actually be pretty damn close. If I can get him out of here. Before he dies. Yes! I win. Yeah, I'm gonna try to kill that lord again. Yeah, my caps lock is on. Not exactly 100% sure if legendary lords can actually die. I think that I may be able to, like, re-recruit him. I think he retreated. Or he died. I prefer the second option over the first. Yes, he died. Yeah, fighting the vampire lords would actually probably be the easiest thing ever. Because once their army starts to, you know, crumble, like that end thing, everyone just dies. Yeah, I think I've seen that actually, like, everyone just dies, all the enemy dies. Once they all start routing completely, there is no, like, oh hey, you have to stop to, you know, do that shit. I'm gonna stomp them to dust, I'm gonna grind their bones, I'm gonna burn down their towns and cities, I'm gonna pile them up, fuck your game. Fuck your game. I use a slightly increase replenish. Into psychology.
chaos.
Sure. Got it. Four turns. Yeah, the Chaos and Ruin is with the Everything mod, and that one I'm kind of getting ass blasted because of the Empire. Because, yeah, they do just get so many armies because they have no... Because no one has any upkeep. So once you start to once the AI just starts to get, like, this much money, they just get every single... They just keep on getting army after army after army after army. And then they just keep on recruiting so many guys into those armies. So then once the army is full, they already have, like, three other armies that are still building up. And then, yeah, it's just like, okay, how do I fight this? Which kind of leads to you going from strength number one or strength number five to, like, strength number, like, 20 in the space of, like, 80 turns. I mean, that may seem like a lot of turns, but in truth, kinda isn't as much. Oh, Jesus, though, this is a really fucking warm computer. Let's see here. Chaos, 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 there. Nah. True. Where's a dwarf settlement? I know. Karak, Karim, Karak. It's like Karaz. No, there isn't. Fuck. Okay. Find Karak Kajrin. Oh, that. Power level 1, what am I talking about? No, let's just limit it to, like, four armies. Yeah, I'm gonna be the brutes. Yeah, sure, these guys could be, like, the human only. And I'm just, like, brutes. Yes, I am building my army from... Nah, I don't like disgusting. These things... I think I have shown them off, but they are just some of the most disgusting things. They are the most disgusting things I've ever seen in this game. I've seen those fucking zombies and whatnot. God's sakes, not even the wolves are that bad, and the wolves are freaky. God's sakes, that one's just like completely like neon yellow green. Chosen. Two chariots. Two of them. Two of them. Oh, a couple half. Two halberds. Two of them. And then just a whole ton of them. just all siege towers. Thorum, Ungor, clicked the wrong person. Give this to heavy army. No, that's a bit much. Have the infinite power over them. I can see why. This is gonna be slaughter. I'm just gonna let my ally go bust down their gates and do as much damage as they can do. And then I'm just gonna come in and sweep. I'm more than positive that one giant can take down that gate, no problem. Two, less problem. Four, no problem at all. Just instant annihilation. I mean, I could have this actually be an all Dragon Ogre team if I wanted to, but I mean, yeah, I used to have a troll, but then I replaced it with a mage to get the Star Crusher, which is his special weapon. Which is apparently not here. Fuck that shit. Damn it. I don't know how to edit him. I don't know how to edit the heroes. You know, I need to fucking see if I can, since I am curious if I can actually, like, get them their shit. No, that wasn't it. That's not it. That's just spell browser. No. So we can increase the rank of them. We can't increase the rank of a hero. Okay, so in other words, no, I can't. Damn it. I mean, this Star Crusher is pretty cool. So it just, like, levels most stuff up. Got it. Any spells and, like, abilities and stuff, it levels up, and I don't think it levels up anything else. Yawns. How you guys doing? Oh, here we go. Sorry, I wasn't listening. Inconsiderate bastard, kind of, but who fucking cares? Oh, all of you care, okay. I'll try to work on that. Probably not, but I mean, it's hard to talk when I can't actually hear you, because you aren't here. But, meh. Hello, giant gearbox of randomness. This is a dwarven settlement. So small. Like, that would be cool to fight on. Like, if they could just, like, expand the map to, like, include the bridge and whatnot, that would be so epic. Because then it's just like, oh no, we need to retreat, have one unit stay here, then have everyone else just, like, line up along the bridge. So that then the enemy has to go after one, after the other, after the other, after the other. Okay.
I
things are really hard to make out detail on, but I think I see the... It's kind of hard to tell which symbol is which, but... Like, I think basically, like, all of the symbols last time I checked are, like, that. It's just, like, they've got, like, little extra pieces on them. Like, I think Corns is just a basic symbol. Tzeentch has the eye in his. I'm not sure about Nurgle or Slaanesh, but each of them have, like, their own color. I think that's what helps. Holy shit! What? Did they just fire their fucking rockets? Did they seriously just do that? Oh my god, the game is running at like 30 fucking frames per second. Probably like half that actually, so like 15. It's lagging quite a bit. Oh, fuck it. I don't think I'm gonna be able to actually show a siege battle properly because recording software alone takes some bit. Then seeing as though it's also telling me. Flank him, shoot him, hit him hard. And then do it again from another angle. Of course, if the battle is going bad from our side, I'm gonna keep writing and act like I was never there. So you'd better stick close. Gitilla the Hunter. Wow, Attila the Hun. That's a bad pun. That's a bad pun, Warhammer. That's a bad pun. Anyway, hope you guys enjoyed. Hopefully more people watch this because it's shorter. I don't know. I mean, not a lot of people are watching the other ones. Probably because they're like hour long, but I want people to like go to... Since I've kind of got this cool thing sort of set up in my mind where I will do those two campaigns, like one video every so often for both of them at the same time. And then whichever one gets more support, whichever combined videos gets more likes, I will be doing... Like, so say the dwarves get 30 combined likes, and then the orcs get 50. So the orcs, I will add up that 50. I think I'll times it by 100. So that'd be like, I'll times it by 1,000. So 50,000 versus 20,000 for a budget. So then I'll do... minor calculations offhand to see, okay, what units can I get with that sort of budget? And then that'll more or less decide, okay, who wins? I'll of course be playing the side of the greater one because sometimes I'm a good strategic, sometimes I'm not. Anyway, hope you guys enjoyed, like, subscribe, whatever, tell me some more other games, and goodbye. One second. There we go. Goodbye. Again. Okay.